Hello guys, welcome and welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Kinesthetic and I'm here with you guys today with a new video. So first of all, happy 2020, happy new year. January has been a busy month already, and I just wanted to sit down and discuss the mindset that I'm going to have for myself and throughout the year of 2020. I know last year I shared like my 2020 goals with you guys, how I curate my planner and my goals for the year. But this year, this time around, I'm going to be focusing more on mindset because I feel like mindset is the first step to conquering your goals, to conquering tasks that you want to do, places you want to go, and everything else. So that's what I'm going to be speaking to you guys about in this video. So before we get started, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit that red subscribe button and down below because I'm giving y'all content all 2020. And we have some big things planned and I want you guys to, you know, come along to join the family and all of that. So subscribe to my channel. If you guys enjoyed this video, give it a big thumbs up so I know what kind of content you guys are enjoying. And after you guys watch this entire video, do not forget to drop a comment down below and let me know your thoughts, opinions, or whatever it may be that's on your mind. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so I basically wrote down a list of four models that I kind of have for myself going into 2020. As I mentioned, mindset is super important. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram, which y'all should, at kinesthetic_, I post a positive affirmation every morning or some type of motivational quote or information for me to start my day with and for others to look at and start their day or their week off with. So through that, I just realized that when you have a better mindset, your day ends up going better, your weeks end up going better, your months end up going better, and ultimately your year ends up being better as well. So these four models are things that I'm going to practice throughout the whole year of 2020, and I'm doing this now so that I can check in with you guys in December of 2020, and I can let you guys know, did these work for me, any feedback or observations that I have about these models. So the first one is less talking and more doing. And this model basically explains why I'm not sharing my 2020 goals with you all, because my goals are all things I want to accomplish, places I want to go, things I want to experience. And I feel like I'd rather show you guys that through my content rather than sitting here and telling you guys one thing and then end up doing another thing. I want to have so much more action in 2020, less talking, lots of planning, and lots of execution. So first thing I want to say is in 2020, I'm doing this, but I'm doing this video to also encourage you guys to do the same too. So let's practice less talking and more doing. The reason why this model is very important to me is because throughout the years and throughout experiences with people and things, I have noticed that I don't really like sharing everything because I feel, I don't like sharing a lot of things before they actually happen or before I actually go or before things basically come into existence, because you'll be surprised by how many people wish bad on you, and it's not a joke at all. And you always want to make sure you're protecting yourself, you're protecting your energy, you're protecting your peace. So this model is very important for me because less talking, more doing, so that you're posting when you do things and you're not really saying, hey, this is what I plan to do, this is what I'm gonna do. And that gives people the opportunity to, one, wish bad on you, two, block your blessings. And we don't need any of that in 2020. So yeah, the first model we're going to live by in 2020 is less talking and more action. The second model for 2020 is to stop giving people access to you. And this one is kind of tricky, and I feel like a lot of times where I say it, people say like, you know, you acting bougie, you acting stush, who do you think you are? But honestly, this more so is around the perspective of protecting your space, protecting your energy, and just protecting the people that you allow to be around you and you allow yourself to be around. And in 2019, one thing that I learned is that, one, I love going out, I love hanging out with my friends, and I love partying. But also, I love making money and I love seeing myself make moves. So often you have to sacrifice often I have to sacrifice one for the other. It's either I'm gonna go out with my friends and have a great time, or I'm gonna stay home and get work done so that I can go to these places that I know I'm gonna go. You see, speaking into existence, power of the tongue, okay? But honestly, a lot of people that I had around me and a lot of people I will be around in 2019, I noticed throughout, you know, the time, one of my lessons of 2019, things that I learned about relationships in 2019. If y'all didn't see that video, go ahead and watch it. But I just learned that some people just aren't for you. Some people are around you because they love your vibe. They love what you have to offer. But ultimately, if they're not supporting you, if they're not here for you, if they're not real friends, then they shouldn't be around you. And you should not be allowing them to have access to you. So that is something that I learned. And hand in hand with that motto, I also saw this quote, which was one of my morning quotes last week. And I stole this from Jackie Aina's caption. So if y'all peeped that, then y'all did. So basically it read, you cannot keep getting mad at people for sucking the life out of you if you keep giving them the straw. Like, when I saw that, I'm like, yo, that is facts. You can't be upset that people are taking away from you and expecting so much from you and just killing your vibe when you give them the opportunity to, when you keep giving them access to you. So in 2020, we just need to stop giving the people who do not deserve it access to us. And when you say it, it might sound stush. People might say you're being bougie and who do you think you are? But honestly, it has to be done and it has to be said, okay? So that is the second model for 2020. The third one is to be consistent in every aspect of your life. So as you guys know, if you guys subscribe to my channel, if you guys watch my videos, I am pretty consistent. I post almost every day on YouTube. I am getting more consistent with posting on my Instagram feed. I'm very active in my Instagram stories. And through my Instagram stories, I kind of post things that I do so that I can inspire you guys to be consistent with things as well, such as fitness. Like, whenever I go to the gym, I at least post one snap so people can see, okay, she made it to the gym X times this week, and I can do it too because, yeah, I have a full-time job. I do YouTube on the side. I work with brands. I still find time to go to the gym. I still find time to hang out with my friends and speak to my friends and be social. So honestly, if I could do it, so can y'all. And that's basically what I want to show you guys throughout me posting. So with me, I noticed that I am consistent here on YouTube, but in real life with certain things, I'm consistent in waves. Like in 2019, that was the most consistent I have been in the gym, and the results have been amazing. And honestly, I was consistent in waves. Like, when I was in between jobs, I wasn't really going to the gym. So that gave me like a month or two breaks in between working out, which wasn't good for me. And yeah, so honestly, I just want to be consistent with every aspect in life. So 2020, I'm going on a fitness journey. I'm going on like a nutrition journey. I'm so much more conscious with the things that I put in my body, things that I eat, things that I put on my skin. So skin journey, hair journey, like, we just have a lot of areas in life that I want to be consistent with. And I plan on showing you guys that through my content here on YouTube as well as Instagram. But I want to inspire you guys as well to be consistent with whatever goals you have. And one video, I'll see if I can insert it here, that I saw early this year that really caused me to make this one of my milestone models for 2020 was that video of Lil Nas X basically showing himself on January 1st, 2019 and himself on January 1st, 2020. That video is absolutely golden because the fact that he's highlighting his growth and sharing it with us and he's so transparent, it just means so much to me. And it's like, if he could do it, and he did it good, like, he did it. Like, when I say he did it, like, he did it, okay? But I'm like, if he could do it, so can we. Like, what are we waiting for? The fourth and last motto that we're going to live by in 2020 is to not wait for anyone and do everything on your own timing. This is so important to me because I cannot count on my fingers and my toes the amount of time and times in 2019, like the amount of instances where I either was waiting for someone, waiting for something, and I'm like, yo, I could have legit just got that done on my own instead of trying to be nice and wait for somebody, or trying to be nice and invite somebody. So in 2020, I'll still, like, I have a certain group of people who I'm like, okay, if I want to go this place or do this, I know I can count on them. So I'll contact them or hit them up and be like X, Y, and Z. But for the most part, honey, I'm doing everything on my own. I want to go on a trip. Nobody want to come. Peace. I'm going on my own. I'm bringing my tripod. I'm getting my pictures and my content in. But 2020, I'm not waiting on anyone. And I made a tweet the other day and I said, let me go ahead and pull it up. And I put it on the screen so y'all can see. But basically what I said is that I absolutely hate when people ask me why I didn't invite them somewhere. I don't invite anyone anywhere. I move on my own time. I don't have time for people. And honestly, that is a move for 2020. Because honestly, when you sit back and think about it and you're like, oh my God, I could have done all of these things had I not been waiting on anyone. Or had I not been waiting on this thing to fall into place or whatever it is. Like, you have the resources. The internet is free 99. Go ahead and do your research and do and get whatever you need, whatever you gotta do. And that's on that period, okay? So those are my four main models that I'm going to live by in 2020. And I just wanted to share them with you all so that you guys can probably, you know, add them to your 2020 shitting ding. Practice them as well. Share them with friends. Share them with family. Share this video. Let's go. 2020, I'm putting content out every other day and I'm trying to grow my audience, grow my platform, and just share more information and insight with you all. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys subscribe to my channel. Hit that red subscribe button down below. Give this video a big thumbs up if you like this video. If this video gave you some insight on things that you want to change or you should change in 2020, drop a comment down below and let me know how you guys feel about this video, how you guys feel about these four models. Comment down below. And until my next video, which will be not tomorrow but the day after tomorrow, I will see you all later.